أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي In technical English lecture today inshallah we will see chapter number 6 it is in page number 22 this is page number 21 after page number 21 this is page number 22 At the end, here it is written, page number 22. Chapter number 6, we will see. Output devices, Jahazet Khal, printers. Technical details. A printer is a device. What is the definition of printer? A printer is a device that prints your text. Your text, you don't write an exam. You write our texts or graphics on paper. Some characteristics, khasais, sifat for a printer. The output on paper or acetate sheet is called printout or hard copy. What is hard copy? When something is printed on the paper from computer by printer. So this paper is known as hard copy when something is printed on the paper. The hard copy or soft copy? Soft copy when it is inside computer memory. When it is printed on the paper, it is hard copy. Then khasiyat number 2, property or characteristic number 2. A program in your computer or our computer called the printer driver converts data into a form that your printer can understand. Whenever we give command to the computer to print something, so there is printer driver. It will convert our instructions, our data into a form, shakl, hasub ya form, that your printer can understand. Then it is printed. The printer driver is a software, not hardware. It is a program. It is written here, a program. It converts our data, our instructions into a form, then printer can understand and then it prints. Printer driver and now hard copy, two important terms. Now term number 3 or khasiyat number 3, print spooler. What is a spooler? It stores file to be printed. When we want a number of files, kathir malfat, to print, then it is printed one by one, wahid bil wahid. When the printer is ready, it lets you change the order of documents in the queue and cancel specific print jobs. The printer spooler is also software, not hardware. It is software. Printer driver is software and our program, and print out it is hard copy when it is on the paper. The printer spooler, what it does, it stores our commands to print a number of files, more than one file it will store, and then it will print. Even it allows us to cancel the documents or to change the order of documents. Suppose five documents, 1 2 3 4 5, I want to print, and I have given print commands for all 1 2 3 4 5 files. Then if we want to print file number five first of all, we can change the order. Or if we don't want to print file number 3, we can cancel this. So this will be done by print spooler. Now the output quality or resolution is measured in dot per inch. What is dots per inch? Kam nukat fi wahid inch. Kam nukta fi wahid inch. Nukta kathir fi wahid inch. Tiba ahsan. Printing quality is very good or better. Ahsan, the output quality, the technical term is resolution. What is the resolution? Even in shashe, television or laptop screen or computer screen, we ask resolution. Resolution means dots per inch. Come dots per inch. More dots per inch, resolution is more and quality is good or better. Less dots per inch, less quality. This is very important, DPI, dots per inch. The speed of your printer is measured in pages per minute. How many pages a printer prints in 1 minute, it is known as pages per minute. This is very important. Suppose this, some printer is printing 1000 pages per minute, it is very good, it is fast. But some printer is printing 50 pages per minute, it is slow. It depends upon business, what business we are doing and what printer we need. Suppose we are having publishing industry, we are publishing some magazines, so we need a faster printer. If we are having something like printing files or malfat, then we need a slow printer, not fast, because faster printer will be costlier, ghali. In a network, now network, users can share a printer connected to a print server. How users can print in a network? So there is a print server, a computer that stores the files waiting to be printed. The print server, there is a print server in a network. It is hardware, it is not software, it is hardware that lets the Zaboon Fishabekat to print their file one by one in queue. Types of printers. How many types of printers we know or we are having or we are knowing? This is cheap, but quality is not very good. A dot matrix printer uses a group or matrix of pins. Here it is pins, to create precise dots. A print head containing tiny pins strikes an inked ribbon to make letters and graphics. This impact printing technology allows shops, for example, to print multi-part forms such as receipts and invoices, so it's useful when self-copying paper is needed. It has two important disadvantages. Noise. It makes noise. It strikes on the ribbon. It hammers on the ribbon and it makes noise. And it is relatively low resolution, from 72 to 180 dots per inch. Its resolution is less. Then quality is also less. Quality is also not good. Next printer in this series, an inkjet, also called bubble jet printer, generates an image by spraying tiny precise drops of ink onto the paper. The resolution ranges from 300 to 1200 dots per inch, suitable for small quantities or home use. A standard inkjet has three color cartridge. Here, what is cartridge? Here it is having ink. It is inside the printer and it is holding the print ink. Sorry, plus a black cartridge. Here three color cartridge, RGB, red, green, blue, to make a color print out. Black for just black printing. Professional inkjets have five color cartridge plus black. Some can print in white format ranging from 60 cm up to 5 meters, as for example for printing advertising graphics. Some inkjet based printers can perform more than one task. They are called multi-function printers because they can work as a scanner, a fax and a photocopier, 3-in-1, a scanner, fax and photocopier, as well as printer, the 4-in-1. They are doing 4 jobs at the same time. They are having fax machine to fax email, a scanner to take photo from, to take a photo on the paper and convert this into digital format so that in computer it can be stored. It is known as a scanner. And a photocopier to do photocopy, surah, server and printer. Some units accept memory cards and print photos directly from a camera. A laser printer uses a laser beams to fix the ink to the paper. A laser, this is a next higher quality printer. and it is famous. Nowadays people are using this printer. They don't want to use a dot matrix printer and inkjet printer, laser printer. Everywhere you will find, almost everywhere. A laser works like a photocopier, a powder called toner. Here it is known as toner. There they are known as a cartridge. Here toner is attracted to paper by an electrostatic charge and then fused on by a hot roller. Laser printers are fast and produce a high resolution of 1200 to 2400 dots per inch. So they are ideal for business and for proofing professional graphics work. Laser use a page description language. See this term, please note this term, page description language. It is software which describes how to print the text and draw the images on the page. So who is using page description language? Laser printers. PDL. If I give you an exam, what is PDL? You write page description language used by laser printers. So don't say in exam, okay, I don't know. What is PDL? Page description language. This is a software used by laser printers to describe how to print the text and draw the images on the page. The best known languages are Adobe PostScript and HP printer control language. A professional image setter is a typesetting printer that generates very high resolution output over 3540 dots per inch on paper or microfilms. It's used for high quality publications. A plotter. Now next higher is plotter. This is very good for graphics only. Plotter is good for picture graphics, not for text. It is less used for text. Generally it is for graphics. A plotter is a special type of printer which uses ink and fine pens held in a carriage to draw detailed designs on paper. It's used in computer aided design, CAD, CAD, maps, 3D, three-dimensional technical illustrations. Three-dimensional means generally two-dimensional, length and breadth, but three-dimensional means depth or height. Generally depth it is known as. Tool, earth, what you say in Arabic, depth, umak, what you say. Okay, this is, so this is all about page number 22, page number 23 perhaps. Page number 22, we see output devices printers. Now on page number 23 there is some exercise, some thumbnail. So you do this, you search this answer and you complete this. So 6.1 and 6.2, you do this by yourself. Very important, 6.1, 6.2 and 6.3. Where you will find this answer, you can search in the chapter. Okay, you search yourself. If you find any difficulty, it is available. Answers are available at the end of the sheet. At the end of the sheet, you go and search in the sheet. It is available. Now we see output devices. Next, chapter number 7, display screens. It is very important. Shashe, CRT and LCD. LCD stands for liquid crystal display and CRT cathode ray tube. This is old, now it is not used. Even in television, old television you can find there is a picture tube. Now it is almost finished, and even from computer it is finished. In laptop it is never used. Yes, in desktop some times before it was used, but now only old computers you will find CRT. Now everyone is using now LCD, even better than this. The screen of a computer is often known as the monitor or shashe or VDU, visual display unit. Don't forget this full form, visual display unit, CPU, central processing unit. remember these terms always because you belong to computer science. Inside the computer there is a video card. See, video card which processes images and sends signals to the monitor. The video card is hardware that processes the images and sends signals to the monitor. When choosing a monitor, you have to take into account a few basics. What are the few criteria? What do you want? Then you buy monitor. Number one, type of display. The choice is between CRT or an LCD. Now CRT is finished almost, picture tube. Only LCD now. Even LCD is now almost finished. Now better quality have come. The cathode ray tube of a monitor is similar to a traditional television set. It has three electron guns, one for each primary color, red, green, blue. What are the primary colors? Red, green, blue, RGB. In short, we say RGB. R for red, G for green, B for blue. That strike the inside of the screen, which is coated with substances called photophosphorus or phosphors, which glow and create colors. Cathode ray tubes are cheap, but they are heavy, can flicker and emit radiation. They emit radiation. LCD, liquid crystal display, is made from flat plates with a liquid crystal resolution between them. The crystals block the light in different quantities to create the image. Active matrix LCDs use TFT, thin film transistor. Please remember this term, thin film transistor. If I ask in exam, just you write full form. What is TFT? The thin film transistor technology, in which each pixel has its own transistor switch. They offer better quality and take up less space, so they are replacing CRT. Now it is almost replaced. CRT is now finished almost. Screen size. Number one, we see we want LCD or CRT or better quality. Number two, what we want? Characteristics of size. Screen size. What size we want? A small, a medium, or large? The viewing area is measured diagonally. See, not in length, not in breadth, but diagonally, from corner to corner. If someone asks, what is the size of your television, then you ask from corner to corner, from zavia to zavia, not from tool and others. In other words, a 17-inch screen measures 17 inches from top left corner to the bottom right. Okay? This is from top left corner to the bottom right. Or from bottom left corner to the top right corner. The corner to the corner. Zavia to zavia. I think zavia in Arabic. Corner. Then resolution. Resolution means how many dots per inch. This is very important. More dots, better quality. The clarity of the image depends on the number of pixels, short for picture elements. What is pixel? Picture elements. It is also important for exam, for computer science students. Pixel, short for picture elements. Contained on a display horizontally and vertically. A typical resolution is 1024x768. This is typical resolution. This is standard. This is good for video quality. The sharpness of images is affected by dot pitch, the distance between the pixels on the screen. So a dot pitch of 0.28 millimeter or less will produce a sharp image. What is dot pitch? Distance between the pixels. Wajid, the sphere, not good. Dot pitch. So what is dot pitch? The distance between the pixels on the screen. Brightness. The luminance of images is measured in CD per meter square, candela per square meter. Brightness. Come brightness we want. Then color depth. The number of colors in a monitor can display. For example, a VGA, video graphic adapter monitor, produces 256 colors. Even now this is old. Enough for home use. A super video graphic adapter can produce up to 16.7 million colors. This is better. We want this type of image with these colors. So is ideal for photographic work and video games. Refresh rate. The number of times that the images is drawn each second. What is refresh rate? The number of times kamadat that the images sura is drawn. You serve fi daqiqa. Fi daqiqa taniya. Second means taniya, I think. Daqiqa for a minute. So this is a refresh rate. Come with what speed it is changing the picture on the screen. If a monitor has a refresh rate of 75 Hz, it means that the screen is scanned 75 times per second. So 75 Hz means 75 times per second screen is scanned. If the rate is low, you will notice a flicker. The speed of picture is coming slower, which can cause eye fatigue. Big screen, now plasma, projection TV. I sometimes use a video projector in my geography lesson. I prepare audio visual presentations on my laptop and then connect it to a front screen projector which displays the images on a distant screen or white wall. I use a portable DLP projector. This is now for projector or plasma TV. Now here is the lesson. You do this by yourself. You search this answer in the lessons and suppose there is some difficulty at the end of the sheet on page number after 90, I think so, answer is given. You can search answer there, but first you try yourself, then you go there. I didn't want to tell you answers, but I told you so that you can find easily. So please find this answer. So don't solve all questions, solve you 7.1, 7.2. Only two, 7.1 and 7.2. Only two. So we completed chapter number 6 and 7. Chapter number 6 from 22 page number and 23, and chapter number 7 it is from page number 24. Now we see chapter number 8, processing, mualij or ualij. The processor The processor, also called the CPU or central processing unit, is the brain of your computer or brain of our computer. In PCs, it is built into a single chip. A small piece of silicon with a complex electrical circuit called an integrated circuit that executes instructions and coordinates the activities of all the other units. To kul shugul fakat fi CPU, mafi shayya shugul fi RAM, a ROM, a fi keyboard. Keyboard only we use to write, to press some characters, and it is stored in RAM. The RAM is storing only some instructions or data or program, but it is doing nothing. Secondary memory, flash memory, CD, DVD, only storing data. If there is no electricity, computer is not on, the secondary memory is permanent, always there will be data. RAM, when computer is on, then only data or instructions will be there. But either ROM, RAM or keyboard or secondary memory is not processing anything. All processing are taking place where? In CPU, central processing unit. Central processing units, we know, have three parts. Number one, control unit, which examines instructions from memory and executes them. Job number one. These are three parts, three hardware parts inside the CPU. And CPU is known as also microprocessor. When it is into a single chip, it is known as a microprocessor. Here it is written microprocessor. See here. It is microprocessor. Generally, we say sanduk CPU. It is not good. Say this system unit. Vahdat nidam. Microprocessor or CPU. CPU old term. Now it is a microprocessor known as. It processes micro instructions. That why it is microprocessor. The number one, control unit, which examines instructions from memory and executes them. Number two, the arithmetic and logical unit, ALU, which performs arithmetical and logical operations. All arithmetical and logical operations. Arithmetical, plus, minus, multiplication, division. What is logical? Logical means if A is greater than B, if C is smaller than D, if B is equal to A, these are logical operations. So job number two, separate hardware device inside this microprocessor. Job number three is the registers. Memory in computer is of different types. RAM is also memory, ROM is also memory, LCD, flash memory, also memory, secondary memory, RAM and ROM, primary memory. Then there is another memory inside CPU, central processing unit, and this memory has special terms, sijilat, registers. Don't forget this, remember for always. Registers means memory inside the CPU, central processing units. Kul mualij yafal hena, fakat. Kul yualij. Kul muali, kul shugul, kul tarhadara qisma, ayyo shugul, akbar or asghar, happens here. The it stores results and programs and data and processing here, arithmetic and logical unit. Kul, arithmetic, that's why its name is arithmetic. Plus, minus, addition and multiplication, subtraction, division, and logical unit say greater than, smaller than, equal to here. But where data is stored inside the CPU, the registers, it is known as the registers. Internal processor memory, second term, it is also known as internal processor memory. High speed units of memory used to store. This is very high. No memory is as higher as registers. This is very high speed of memory. The speed of processor is measured in gigahertz. Thus, a CPU running at 4 gigahertz can make about 4000 millions calculations a second. If it is 4 gigahertz, 4000 million calculations a second. An internal clock sends out signals at fixed intervals to measure and synchronize the flow of data. The speed of a processor is measured in gigahertz. I am repeating, and in The main circuit board is known as the motherboard. Main circuit board, where all other devices are attached, it is known as motherboard. This contains the CPU, the memory chips, RAM, ROM, expansion slots where we insert a flash memory and a speaker and other devices, other peripheral devices, and controllers for peripherals connected by internal buses or paths that carry electronic signals. For example, the front side bus carries all data that passes from CPU to other devices. Expansion slots allow you to install expansion cards which provide extra functions, as for example a video card or a modem. What is modem? Modem, it converts data digitally. Okay, when we use the telephone line to send the data on internet, so telephone line is analog, it creates signals, but computer uses digital data 0 and 1. It will convert from 0, from analog ishara or tayasi to 0 1, to demodulator from the source, and on the target it will reverse from digital to analog signal, it will convert. Laptops have PC cards the size of a credit card, which add features like sound, memory and network capabilities. So PC cards laptops have. For what? For sound, for memory and network capabilities. RAM and ROM, primary memory. When you run a program, the CPU looks for it on the hard disk and transfers a copy into the RAM. RAM, random access memory, is temporarily or volatile. It is volatile. That is, it holds data while your PC is working on, when power is on, when computer is on. But when you close the computer, nothing is there, but loses this data when the power is switched off. However, ROM, read-only memory, is permanent. It is prepared by the company. We don't write inside the ROM. We don't change it. And contains instructions needed by the CPU. It contains instructions for the CPU. The BIOS, basic input-output system. If I ask you, so don't say in exam, I don't know. What is BIOS? ROM BIOS, generally it is known as ROM BIOS. Read-only memory, basic input-output system. Uses ROM to control communications with peripherals like disk drives. The amount of RAM determines the number of programs you can run simultaneously. Simultaneously means at the same time. Simultaneously at the same time means the amount of RAM. The RAM is bigger, then more programs we can run at the same time. And how fast they operate. It can be expanded by adding extra RAM chips. Units of memory. The electronic circuits in computers detect the difference between two states. On, the current passes through, or off, the current doesn't. They represent these states as one. When on, when yes, when high, it is one. When there is kerba, it is one. When it is off, when it is low, when it is no, then it is zero. Each one or zero is called a binary digit, bit. The bit BI, binary, and D for digit, the binary digit. BI for binary, D for digit. This is a byte, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The combination group, majmua, tamania, bit, it is known as byte. One character, it represents one character. But when it is only 1, 0 or 1, this is binary, this is not decimal. We are having different type of numbers. Binary numbers, then octal number, then decimal number, then hexa number. So it is binary number. Bits are grouped into 8-digit codes that typically represent characters, letters, numbers and symbols. Each 8 bits together are called byte. For example, this is used for the character A. If you calculate this, if you convert this from binary to digital, binary to a decimal number, it will come 65 for capital A. For a small A, it is 97. For a capital B, it is 66. but it is for A, it is 65 if you convert this. Computers use a standard code called ASCII. What is ASCII? American Standard Code for Information Interchange. It is not written here. I am repeating. American Standard Code for Information Interchange for the binary representation of characters. In order to avoid complex calculations of bytes, we use bigger units, a kilobyte. Kilobyte means 1000 byte. On exact 1024 bytes. It is 2 to the power 10. It is 2 to the power 10. 1 kilo. Kilo means somewhat near to 1 kilo gram. But 1 kilo we know only 1 triple 0. 1 then 3 zeros. But here it is not 130. 1024. Please remember this. And a megabyte. 1024 kilobytes. This. 2 to the power 20. A gigabyte. 1024 megabytes. 2 to the power 30. Then a terabyte. 1024 gigabytes equal to 2 to the power 40. Now we are having more units than this. We use these units to describe the RAM memory or secondary memory, the operating capacities of disks, and the size of a program or document. Now you solve this 8.1 and 8.2, but 8.2, if I give you, you may confuse. You leave 8.2, 8.3 you do, 8.1 and 8.3. Leave it. 8.1 and 8.3. You do this, and you can find answers at the end of the sheet. If you find any difficulty, you can write in Messenger. Any one of you from your group, you can write. So, see you inshallah in next lecture. Today we have completed 3 chapters, and earlier we completed 2 chapters. So, 5 chapters alhamdulillah we have completed. Inshallah, see you in next lecture.